What's up, y'all? It's your boy GDR Man here with another one, and you're tuning into my channel, Cutting It Up with GDR Man. This month, we're gonna highlight some historical spots or neighborhoods in Houston that I stay in, commemorating African American history, which is Black History Month, over here in America, the UK, Netherlands, and we're gonna be in the historic Third Ward, Houston, southeast of downtown Houston. This client I know, she's a old coworker of mine from years ago, and it's hard to keep a lawn, man. So, hey, she said, hey, G, I know you're cutting grass. You mind stopping by taking care of me? Absolutely. So, we're going to showcase this yard here. We do the hedges. We're going to clean up the yard. It's not hot. You know, like I said, it's winter time. I'm ready for spring to bud up. I am. So, we're going to do the leaf cleanup, of course. Clean it nice and neat. Edge it up. Blow it down. Clean the fence line. And after this video, stay tuned through the whole thing, please, for me. I'm going to go ahead and showcase a little history tidbit for you all, maybe a minute or so about, you know, historical Third Ward. So let's get into it. Let's knock this out. Get this baby on the fish, y'all. Holla. All right, this is the walkthrough of the property. Full of leaves, as we can see here. I'm gonna go ahead and shape the hedges up. Them all even, looking good, manicured. And we're gonna get the fence line too. Get all this little overhanging vines and things like that. Just clean up a little bit. And we're gonna cut. The main thing, let's get these hedges looking level. Level. Spruce them up just a tad bit. Get all the old winter foliage out the way. Yeah. That's the problem. So let's go ahead and tackle this baby. Get it looking good on the official line. Okay, as you see, we didn't, I say we because y'all watching me. Y'all part of the team, y'all all unofficial. But I got the fence line cleaned up. Got some of this tree knocked out. You see, it's a power line, so I'm not even going to deal with that. If you looked at my previous video that I posted with them palms, it was a power line there, and it was dangerous. So I don't commend anybody to do that for YouTube. It's crazy. Safety is always first. So like I said, I'm not dealing with that. That's behind her property anyway. We're gonna go ahead and take care of this fence line right here in front. Everything behind, that's not my problem. We're gonna do everything in the front. So I know it's kind of slow for y'all, but at the same time, this is what it takes. So back to it. Let's get this back of this fence line and we'll keep this thing going. Thanks for watching. Well, I got it done, as y'all can see. Best is my ability. Still, you know, all this water we had, the grass kind of wet a little bit, but it looks good. It looks good. You know, the hedges came out pretty decent. Pretty decent. Yeah, it came out pretty good. Came out pretty good, y'all. Fence line also, it wasn't too bad, but these power lines, and like I said in the previous video, I got kind of close and I will never do that again. But here go the fence line, is all cleaned up. No vines, no old sticks and things of that nature. It's all cleaned up. We're gonna go to the other side. There we go. Looking good, looking good. Nice. I had to kind of shape this a little bit. It's not growing right. I wanted to cut it down, but she said leave it. Knock this down, just lift this up. Hopefully the bud back out. Lastly, backyard. It's all cleaned up. Pretty good, pretty good. Oh, this is clean. This is what they were worried about. Everything behind that is not my issue. Everything in front is what you know, I took care of. So, there you have it. That's the white walkthrough of this historic property in a third ward. Well, I'm back with y'all. And before we go into this brief little history of third ward and the significance of it within Houston, I want to thank you all for tuning in, checking out my videos, watching them, y'all. For those who have subscribed, thank you, thank you. For those who haven't, it's about 89% of y'all who haven't subscribed, which that's okay. But if y'all could, just take it a little notch and just go ahead and subscribe for your boy, please. That would be great, so I can continue to, you know, broadcast this throughout, you know, my area, throughout the world. You know, I'm getting people hollering at me from the Netherlands, which is awesome. They're loving what I do, so I want to keep doing it, y'all, for y'all. You know, this is not a hobby. I mean, I do this for a living, I do, but the special videos that I do showcase these for people that really they don't have the means to support it, you know, themselves for lawn cutting. So I take them on myself and I cut for these people, you know, and try to make sure that everything is on point for them. So if you could, please subscribe. If not, can you please just share it with those who wouldn't mind subscribing and give me those thumbs up, y'all. Give me those thumbs up because this keeps my content, you know, scattered, however YouTube do it, you know, so other people can see it, you know, enjoy it. You know what I'm saying? Taking notes from how I cut. This is the way I cut. So until the next one, y'all, GDR Man is out. Y'all can look at other videos that I have posted, you know, so far. And remember to help those who can't help themselves, because we might be in a bind and we're gonna need some help too. So just remember that, you know, whatever you do, it does come full circle. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not gonna be too long-winded. I appreciate y'all. Until the next one, GDR Man is out. Be blessed, stay healthy and well. Stay long official. I'm out. In 1837, Houston, Texas was incorporated and divided into four wards, the Southeast Ward, Third Ward, and over time became an important center of African American owned businesses and a hub for black culture. Most of the social activism from the African American community grew out of Third Ward. Emancipation Park, the first park for Black Houstonians and home to the annual Juneteenth celebration commemorating the liberation of African Americans from slavery in Texas. The Buffalo Soldiers National Museum, located in Houston, Texas, is a museum dedicated to the history and achievements of Buffalo soldiers and African American soldiers from all the branches of the United States military.
Texas Southern University is a public, historically Black university in Houston, Texas. The university is one of the largest and most comprehensive historically Black college or universities in the United States, with nearly 10,000 students enrolled in over 100 academic programs.
So in closing, there is a lot of African American history in Houston. Third Ward is just one of the few jewels areas that has comprised of a lot of African American history and advancements, but I will later showcase a few more. So thank you for tuning in and watching this little history tidbit. Until the next one, y'all stay long official, be blessed, and always help those who are in need, because you never know, you might need a helping hand. Until the next one, y'all, holla.